And we've got a little Canadian showdown here because the next pair to skate, after the short, Jacinta LaRubiere of Princeville, Quebec, and Lenny Faustino from Woodbridge. And again, the battle to be number two, a position once held by the Wurtzes, and we'd like to say hello to them, announcing their retirement this season from competitive skating. We know they're watching with great anticipation tonight.
Lenny and Jazz also had difficulties in the short program. Couldn't quite get comfortable, but we'll see right off the bat here just how comfortable they are here, because they're opening with the most difficult element for them. Side-by-side triple toe loop.
Juliet is the music. Here's a split triple twist. A little unorthodox in the way her arm position is on the landing, but good patience shown, and they pushed it out cleanly.
This is key right here, side-by-side double axles. Jazz turns out on the landing. Where this team excels. They have great lifts.
Throw triple sal cow. Thank you.
hope to have skated any better than this. This is a personal best.
Runners up to Sally and Pelche at the Nationals, and that expression confirms what Barb Underhill just told you. And it looks like they will be the number two seed Canadian team here at this Olympic Games.
I'm getting chills here because, you know, this is what you hope for. You hope to stand out on this ice and do the best that you can do, and they did. Yes, there were a couple of small glitches on the side-by-side jumps, but those jumps are not really, really consistent for them. So I think this was as much as they could have hoped for.
And when you come to the Olympic Games, never having been to a world championship before, you know, you come to the Olympics, not even having competed against the very best in the world, it's a huge accomplishment. Here was the opening side-by-side triple toes, a little bit of unison off there as they go into it, but they both get the jump done. They make it a sequence, and attack on a little double toe here at the end. A jump sequence is one of the required elements here in the free skate.
And this is an element they just added to their program this year. It's not a consistent one, but she goes for it. She attacks it. Doesn't quite get all the rotation or the height that she needed to complete that, but it was great to see her go for it.
The throws were superb. Throw triple Saukow. She just wasn't going to quit on anything out there tonight. There were a couple of things that were a little out of shape on her, but she was not going to let any of them get away.
Much more settled the second night of Olympic competition. Remember, this was the team that skated last of the 20 pairs on opening night. Part of the Mariposa Club.
Coached by Lee Markell.
Technical merit.
Lenny's sister flew in from Italy to watch little brother. I once asked him if he skated with his sister, and he gave me that look like, are you kidding me?
5-3.
That's a great set of marks.
5-2.
4-8 from the American judge, but up to 5.3 from the judge from China. Lenny rooming with Elvis Stoiko here. It's just a great experience all around, and he's been wide-eyed. And the presentation marks, and that's the key ordinal for them. They are in first place, so they will be the number two Canadian team here at the Olympic Games and could even improve on their 13th after the short. So a good start here at the Salt Lake Ice Center. Our coverage of the 2002 Olympic Winter Games from Salt Lake City continues.